how's it going, everybody, and welcome to Diode. Today let's talk about a pair of shoes that can make you run like Flash, a swimsuit that transforms you into Ripjaws without the Omnitrix, and a bike that makes you much faster than a Williams F1 car.
Well, everyone's faster than a Williams.
Using these equipments make you so OP that you might also be called a superhuman, or as common folks say in a sport, a cheater. And kids, cheating ain't good. So let's dive right into the video, shall we? Starting with one of the most iconic brands in sports, recognized all over the world with its iconic swoosh, Nike and its
VaporFly
running shoes. The shoes cushioned the feet of all the three medallists in the men's marathon at Rio Olympics. Later that year, they were worn by all the winners of major marathons in Berlin, Chicago, and New York. The latest shoe designs have produced fast times and impressive results in international races, but they have also spurred yet another debate about the advancement of technology and the gray area where innovation exploited the loopholes in some extremely vague rules about what is considered unfair performance enhancement for the feet. The Nike shoe used by the medalists in the Rio Olympics, which retailed for a whopping $250, is called Zoom VaporFly. The shoe to be used for breaking two, as Nike calls its effort to crack the 2-hour mark in marathon. The shoe weighs a feather-like 184 grams and features a thick but lightweight midsole, and is set to return 13% more energy than more conventional foam midsoles. Some runners have said that the shoe reduces fatigue in their legs. At least someone's admitting they're cheating. Embedded in the length of midsole is a thin, stiff carbon fiber plate, which is somewhat curved like a blade. The plate is designed to reduce the amount of oxygen needed to run at the fast pace. It stores and releases energy with each stride and is meant to act as kind of a spring or a slingshot to bounce the runners forward. Nike says that the carbon fiber plate saves 4% of the energy needed to run at a given speed when compared to another popular racing shoe. The rule does say that all types of competition shoes must be approved by the IAAF. Nike said that it was unaware of any formal approval process and that the shoe companies do not routinely submit their shoes for inspection. Nike officials said that they were working closely with the IAAF on course to design and drug testing for the Breaking 2 project and would be sharing the shoes with the governing body. They also noted that carbon fiber soles have been used before in the running shoe industry. Up next, we'll dive into the pool of swimming.
You see what I did there?
But poor jokes apart, the company that gets the spotlight here is Speedo. I mean, if you're into swimming, you might already be using some gear from this iconic brand. I mean, the swimsuits are often referred to as Speedos, just like photocopying is referred to as Xerox. But Speedo, in association with NASA, believe it or not, went a bit overboard with their LZR laser technology. Well, swimsuits have come a long way since, believe it or not, cotton that actually soaks up all the water and may very much sink you, to spandex, and now to even more finely woven nylon. But what's stopping humans to reach those torpedo speeds?
Their own speed.
According to NASA and Speedo, the limiting factor for humans to reach fish-like speeds in water is the drag that accounts for 25% of retarding forces on a polished swimmer, and it is generously offered by the porous and hairy human skin. So what alchemy did they perform? They just copied the fundamentals of a shark skin, which we, the people of science, also refer to as biomimicry. Speedo and NASA came up with this fabric, so fine, so smooth, that suit is capable of reducing the drag
or the water resistance up to 38% compared to an ordinary lycra suit. This reduction in drag translates into approximately a 4% increase in speed of a swimmer. That is insane! The most advantageous advancement in swimming since the inception of swimming goggles in 1976. But you know what? In the span of February to August of 2008, the suit had helped breaking 62 world records. 62! But as of now, full body suits stand banned for men. The next segment is 100% real though, and it is a weird one, but it has a true spirit of a backyard scientist. On the 17th of July 1993, a relatively unknown cyclist from Scotland did the unthinkable. He smashed the world hour record on his homemade bicycle named Old Faithful. Graham Aubrey's unorthodox bike was the culmination of years of experimenting with aerodynamics and durability, and his success marked the start of a professional career defined by cycling innovation. The world hour record is as simple as it sounds. Cycle as far and as fast as you can in 1 hour. Yet of all the record holders, only one claimed the record on a bicycle made in Ayrshire kitchen with wheel bearings from good old washing machine parts. Don't start laughing as of now. Every choice Graham Aubrey made building Old Faithful was designed to increase the speed and endurance. Aubrey made the bottom bracket, the part which connects the crankset and the chain to a bike, deliberately narrow. He used washing machine bearings when standard bike bearings were unsuitable. A test to see if they were a higher quality. The wheel fork only had one blade and the shoes were fixed to the pedals, increasing resistance against the cyclist's body. Aubrey even invented a new aerodynamic cycling position, the tuck, the hunched over handlebars, arms folded away in the chest. Taken together, bike in position reduced aerodynamic drag by around a whopping 15%. On 17 July 1993, Aubrey broke the world hour record at Hammer Velodrome in Norway, riding 51.596 km on the Old Faithful. Very questionable upgrades. So that should be it for this video, guys. If you've made this far, please consider subscribing, and a like will surely make my day. A lot more lesser known alleys of science will be discovered in the future videos, so make sure to be a part of the family. To know more about Diet Media's goals, make sure to check out the About section. And for fun tech memes, trends and updates about the channel, make sure to follow us on our social handles. All the links are in the description. So until next time, bye. Nowadays is all about this.